And I'd say I do for the rest of my life. With all that I have, I do. And I will, when the sky is falling, I promise you I'm all in, no turning back. And every day, every moment, every breath you take. I choose you.
We're gathered here at the sight of God in the presence of family and friends to celebrate the marriage of Jacob Thomas Phipps Morris and Michaela Ryann Barilla. 1 Corinthians 13. We have to go there on a wedding day. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It's not proud. It's not rude or self-seeking. It's not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. So the kind of love we're talking about today is a love that would be virtually impossible for any of us to possess or sustain over time in and of ourselves alone. It's a love that can only be experienced and realized when we allow God to become that third strand of this matrimonial cord, because His love truly can never fail. Colossians 3, verse 12 to 14 says, "As God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other, and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity." Love and forgiveness is the best advice I could give you. So stay close to God together. Read His Word together. Pray together. Go to church and serve the Lord together. Do ministry together. Are you willing to take Ryann to be your wife? Ryann, are you willing to take Jacob to be your husband, to live together in marriage from this day forward? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and support her in sickness and in health, in poverty or in wealth? Will you devote yourself to Him as long as you both shall live according to God's holy ordinance?
I will.
I will.
Say, Ryann, I pledge my undying love.
Ryann, I pledge my undying love.
Respect and devotion to you.
Respect and devotion to you.
From this moment on.
From this moment on.
I pray that with God's help.
I pray that with God's help.
I will be a faithful, loving wife.
I will be a faithful, loving wife.
And that whether times are easy or hard. She can relapse. I will be committed. I will be committed to you for the rest of my life.
I will be committed to you for the rest of my life.
I will be committed to you for the rest of my life.
Ryann, I give you this ring.
Ryann, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love for you.
As a symbol of my love for you.
And my promise to be your faithful wife.
And my promise to be your faithful wife.
And my promise to be your faithful husband.
Heavenly Father, we so thank you for Jacob and Ryann's lives. I pray for your blessing over their lives, over their marriage. We love you. We thank you that they have chosen to keep you at the center. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Jacob and Ryann have chosen to take communion together as their first act of marriage. And during that moment, they will also share their personal vows with one another privately. So Jacob and Ryann, since we've heard you make these pledges of love and affection to one another and your vows of devotion by the giving and receiving of rings before God and these witnesses, and by the authority vested in me by the state of Pennsylvania, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Now in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, what God has joined together, let no one ever separate or tear apart. Jacob, you may kiss your bride. Now it's with great pleasure that I introduce to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Jacob Fitzmaurice.
I look out the window, the birds are composing. Not a note is out of tune or out of place.
Alrighty, so now that we had some fun, you know, we're ready to go. But first, we got some speeches from some of the members of the bridal party.
And so, like I said, such an honor for me to have not only been part of your wedding party, but to have lifelong friends with two amazing people, two people that I know have a deep, deep love for God and for other people. Together, I've seen a force to be reckoned with that has already changed so many lives. I guarantee every single person in this room can attest that the two of you together are such a force for God and force for good. I can't wait to see what you guys do in your lives and where this relationship takes you, and I'm so happy that I get to be a part of it.
May you, Jacob and Ryann, always stand side by side. May your souls be shaped through joy and sorrow alike by long obedience to the promises you made today. May your marriage flourish into a living testimony of his love. And may the comforting presence of Christ always be yours. To Jacob and Ryann.
Jacob, Jacopo. I didn't have a sibling until I was 13 years old. Now I have brothers, so I can't say he was the brother I always wanted but never had. But he was the brother that was my age that I never had. Ryann, I wanted to talk to you. The way that I've seen Jacob love you, I've never seen. What I will say is that even though you are a Michigan fan, you are now my sister as well.
I took the time to ask some of our family what their marriage advice would be, and they did not disappoint. Remember, you're on the same team. Work together, not against each other. Love starts and ends with your willingness to do what Jesus has already done for you. But Jacob, my advice to you is don't forget to say those three little words. Please stop talking.
Jacob, I haven't known you very long. A couple of things stood out right away. One was your love of God. Two was your respect of elders. And three is your love of Ryann. I've raised my children. I've done the things that God has asked me to do. And now it's my time to turn it over to you. Take care of her. Be with her. Praise her. And love her. So, thank you very much.